Hey guys, welcome back to Best Movies Recap. Today we are going to explain a science fiction movie from the year 2015. The story is about a former burglar who wants to find a job and start a new life for his daughter, but unfortunately, his criminal record prevented this, which forced him to go back to his former life again one last time. During a heist, he successfully cracks a safe, but he couldn't find any money except a special suit which will turn his life upside down. Without any further delays, let's get started. The movie begins in the year 1989, where Hank Pym enters a SHIELD facility to confront Howard Stark, Peggy Carter, and Mitchell Carson over trying to replicate a serum of his that he refers to as the Pym Particle. This serum can be used to shrink anything, and if something like this fell into the wrong hands, it could spell chaos around the world. However, the board members there didn't agree with him, and Carson makes a comment about Hank not being as ferocious in saving his wife Janet, which made the latter angry. Then he slams Carson's face down on the table and resigns. The scene shifts few years later, where a prisoner named Scott Lang is getting punched in the face by an inmate. Lang hit him back, then the two shake hands and hug each other. This turns out to be a goodbye ritual in the prison. After that, Scott leaves the prison, and he is picked up by his best friend Louise, who offers to let him stay at his apartment and helps him to find a job at Baskin-Robbins. Unfortunately, despite that, the manager thinks that Scott's robbery crimes are cool, he fired him from the job due to his criminal history. Lang returns home and reveals the bad news to Louise, who introduces him to his two other partners, Kurt Gorister and Dave, who offer him a position in a burglary. However, Lang shows his intention of going straight and leaving his old life in the past. Meanwhile, at the Pym Tech Company, Hank returns after vanishing for many years, which surprises all the workers there. He is then reunited with his daughter Hope Van Dyne, who has been estranged from her father since her mother's death, as well as his former protege Darren Cross, who now runs the place. Darren leads Hank and all the invited into a room to unveil his latest project, a weaponized yellow jacket suit, based on Hank's old Ant-Man project. With this suit, the user can shrink to a very small size and defeat enemies using the strength provided by it. Darren's goal is to create an army of yellow jackets to protect the world. During the presentation, a man named Frank didn't like this idea, citing the project as expensive and dangerous, especially if this technology ended up in the enemy's hand. Just as the presentation ends, Cross finds Frank in the bathroom and vaporizes him into a blob of goo, then he wipes it up and flushed it down to the toilet. On the other side, Lang borrows Louise's van and makes a surprise appearance at the birthday party of his daughter Cassie. He runs into his ex-wife fiancé Jim Paxton, who is not happy to see Scott there. However, Cassie is very happy to see her dad, and she loves the ugly little doll that he gives her as a gift. At this moment, his ex-wife Maggie joins them and tells Scott that he has to find a legitimate job and pay off his delinquent child support before she will allow him to visit Cassie. Lang, who feels sad, said a final goodbye to Cassie and leaves. He then goes back to the apartment and asks Louise about the tip he heard about. The latter learned through several sources that there is a home that contains a safe with something worth taking inside it, and the owner of the house will be out for the week. Since Scott has no other option but to pay the child support, he accepts to join them. Later on that night, Kurt climbs up a pole outside the house and blocks the electrical circuit, cutting off all phone communication. After that, Scott climbs the fence and takes out the window sensors, then opens a window and heads to the basement. But after he unlocks the basement door, he finds a second door with a fingerprint. However, he finds a solution by using tape to lift the man print and used it to open that door. Behind it, Lang finds the safe made of particularly strong metal. So he drills small holes around the lock, then squirts in water and uses nitrogen to freeze it. The frozen water expands, which warps the steel and causes the bolts to shoot out. But the only thing he finds inside the safe is just a weird-looking bodysuit and helmet. Scott grabs that and heads out. Meanwhile, Hank has been watching everything with a little ant carrying a camera. At the Pym Tech, Hope and Darren are trying to shrink sheep to microscopic size. But their experiment fails and the sheep is killed. However, Darren insists they press forward with another sheep. At home, Scott goes into the bathroom and examines the suit he stole earlier, wondering why it was so heavily guarded. Out of curiosity, he puts the suit on and steps into the bathtub to get a better look at himself in the mirror. Noticing a red button on the glove, he pushes it and instantly shrinks down to a tiny size. Already in shock, Scott then hears Hank's voice speaking to him through the mask. Luis then enters to take a shower, splashing Scott with water as he turns it on. Lang gets out of the tub and falls through a hole in the apartment below, where a loud party is going on. He narrowly avoids getting stepped on before falling through the vent where he encounters a mouse that tries to eat him. While escaping, Scott runs into a mousetrap which sends him flying out through the window into the rainy night before landing on a car. The impact jarred the blue button free, and he grows back to normal size. At this moment, Lang decides to return the suit to Hank's safe. He easily breaks into the house again and puts the suit back. Unfortunately, as he gets out of the house, he finds the cops waiting for him, then he is arrested. In the prison cell, Paxton tells Scott that Maggie and Cassie will be disappointed to learn that he got locked up again for stealing. He is then told that his lawyer is there to see him. Confused, Scott goes to see the lawyer that he had not asked for. The lawyer waiting turns out to be Hank Pym, who reveals that the heist was a setup from the beginning to get Louise's friends to tip him off about the house with the big safe inside it. As they talk, ants crawl over the camera to obscure the conversation. Hank offers Scott two choices: he either stays in prison for the next few years away from his daughter, or he works for Hank, and he will help him to get back his life and his daughter. Scott is taken back to his cell, where several controlled ants bring him the suit in its tiny form, then turn it big, so he can quickly slip into it and escape. At this moment, the police discover the empty cell, and they start a manhunt for him, though Lang is already flying out on the back of a winged ant. As they fly, he feels dizzy and he falls off the ant's back. The next morning, Scott wakes up in the bedroom of the house he broke into. Hope is in the room, unhappy to see him again. They then meet Hank, who explains to his daughter why he needs Scott for this job. It turns out that Hank was watching him for a while, and he needs Scott to steal something. He also tells Scott that he invented the shrinking suit, but was afraid it would be misused, so he locked it away. However, his former assistant Darren had found out about the shrinking technology, and because Hank didn't want to share it with him, Darren forced him out of Pym Tech. When Hope realized how dangerous Darren was, she teamed up with Hank to stop him, but they need Scott to help with that. Lang refuses and suggests they call the Avengers for help. But Hank already refused to work with Tony Stark because it is too risky to share this technology with others. At this moment, Hope interferes and offers to be the one who uses the suit, but her father did not accept. He then tells Scott that he needs him to become the Ant-Man to stop bad people like Darren from destroying the world and also become the true hero that Cassie always dreamed about. Meanwhile, we see Darren performing the shrinking experiments again with a baby sheep. But this time he placed it in a glass container, and it shrunk in without negative results. During the next few days, Hank and Hope train Scott to properly use the suit. He needs to be fast, agile, and able to communicate with the ants the same way Hank does. In the beginning, he fails many times until he talks to Hope, who tells him to clear his mind by thinking of Cassie as motivation to get the ants under his control. With that, he finally gets the ants to spin a penny. Over time, Scott uses the suit properly and befriends the ants, naming one Anthony. After that, Hank tells him that they will need one piece of technology to steal the suit from Darren, and this particular item is stocked in an abandoned SHIELD building. When Scott flies to the building, he sees that it's the current Avengers headquarters. Pressing forward, he lands on the roof, triggering a sensor. Sam Wilson arrives to investigate. He spots Scott despite his small size and forces him to show up. After that, a battle ensues with Ant-Man getting the upper hand with his small size. Scott goes inside Falcon's jetpack and causes it to short out. He then takes the equipment he needs and escapes. Back at the house, Hank finally tells Hope what really happened to her mother. It turns out that her mother vanished during a mission to stop a missile. Hank was in his Ant-Man suit, while Janet in her Wasp suit intercepted the missile, but they couldn't break into it. And since there was a problem in Hank's suit, Janet compromised her regulator and went subatomic, shrinking herself small enough to stop the missile. However, she couldn't return from that size and was lost in the quantum realm. Because of that, Hank vanished for 10 years to study the quantum realm to get back his wife, but he couldn't. After hearing the truth, Hope cries and forgives her father. Later on that night, Darren makes a surprise visit to Hank while he was discussing the plan with Scott and Hope. The two hide inside while Cross invites Hank to Pymtech the following evening. After he leaves, he calls Hope and tells her that he is going to add more security to protect the suit. She tells her father to cancel the heist, but Hank insists because it is their last chance. Knowing there will be tight security, Scott suggests sneaking in through the water system, but to do this they gonna need more members, so he enlists the help of Luis, Dave, and Kurt to Hank and Hope's dismay. The next evening. Hope gets in by attendance while the guys help Scott and the ants to get in. Luis sneaks in as a security guard, avoiding being compromised and lowering the water level. Meanwhile, Paxton and his partner spot Hank outside, and they try to arrest him. But Dave creates a diversion by stealing their car, allowing Hank to get in. After he gets back to the van, he accidentally honks the horn that has a special tune which Paxton recognizes from Scott using it earlier with Cassie. The policemen find the two and try to arrest them, but Kurt manages to take out the laser grid above the yellowjacket suit in the last second, and Scott makes it in. Only to be found out by Darren as he is with Hank, Hope, Carson, and several Hydra buyers. Darren attempts to kill Hank, but Scott breaks out using some discs Hank gave him that turn things large. During the chaos, Hank is shot in the shoulder. They then break out by turning a tiny tank to full size and ride it out the side of the building. Meanwhile, Scott makes it to the chopper, where Cross tries to shoot him and manages to kill Anthony, which made Lang angry, and vows to make Cross regret it. A battle followed in the chopper, just as the PIM Technologies building vanished with bombs Scott put on earlier. Darren puts on the yellowjacket suit and fires lasers at Scott, hitting the pilots. As Scott and Cross shrink, they fall out of the chopper in the briefcase fighting. The two lands in a family's pool, then Ant-Man causes a shrunken Cross to fly into a bug zapper. At this moment, Jim Paxton shows up and arrests Scott before he can destroy the suit. On the ride back to jail, the cops hear of a disturbance from Paxton home. Lang knows that Cross went after Cassie. Sure enough, he's standing in her room menacingly, holding her hostage while Maggie is outside helpless. Scott arrives and battles Cross. They fight all around the room, shrinking and growing. Lang throws a disc by mistake and causes an ant and Thomas the toy to grow. At this moment, Paxton runs to the room to protect Cassie. But Cross aims his lasers at them as a tiny Scott tried to break into the yellowjacket suit. But the titanium is too strong for him to break into, so he decides to go subatomic, despite Hank's warnings. Scott shrinks to a small enough size to break into Cross's particle pack, causing him to also go subatomic and disappear into oblivion. Lang is trapped in the quantum realm, but hears Cassie's voice calling to him. He takes a blue disc and places it in the reactor, allowing him to return to normal size. He then embraces his little daughter Cassie. After that, a grateful Paxton covers for Scott, so he would not have to go back to prison. The next morning, Hank questions Lang about how he got out of the subatomic space, and wonders if Janet could have gotten out too. Scott then rejoins his friends, and Luis tells him that the Falcon is looking for him. Later on that day, Lang has dinner with Paxton, Maggie, and Cassie. As gratitude for his heroism, Paxton lets Scott off the hook and covers for him. Then we see Cassie giving food to the giant ant. In the mid-credits scene, Hank brings Hope down to his lab and shows a prototype wasp suit that he and Janet decided to make for her. In the last scene of the movie, Falcon joins Steve Rogers in a dark room where they find Bucky Barnes. Steve doesn't want to tell Tony about this, and Falcon says he knows a guy.